Even smelling them. You remember that? I'm just in the mood to find a picture. So anyway, look at that. It's been a fun week, but it's been really, really busy, and I'm kind of tired. Isn't that like a fun picture just to look at? I'm debating now if I want to make a collage out of these. Or just like have these sitting around the house for fun. Like sitting on my favorite chair. On the little lozy. Sometimes it's just fun to have fun pictures to look at. I got one of those $5 meals. I got one of those $5 meals. You know what I couldn't believe? KFC is right next to McDonald's. And at 3 o'clock, the school across the street is out, and the kids dart right across. really good little deal, Kentucky Fried Chicken. $5, you get two pieces of chicken, a medium soda pop, a freshly baked chocolate chip cookie, and a nice, good-sized side order of mashed potatoes or whatever you want. We got mashed potatoes. And you get a biscuit in a little box. How do you eat a biscuit without butter or honey? I don't know. But for $5, you guys, if you want a fun little treat, I would go through the KFC drive-thru and get you one of those $5. I think it's called a fun meal. I'm not sure. Or a fun box. The idea behind that was I was going to do an Eat With Me video. Nope, that never happened. So anyways, we're going to be out again today. I might try it again. It was that good, you guys. And if you don't want mashed potatoes and gravy, you can get another side. But I guess you have to ask them to throw in the butter and the honey. Or they don't do it automatic. So we did that, and then you'll never believe what I did at McDonald's. This week has been so hectic. Can you believe I ran out of coffee grinds? I cannot believe I ran out of coffee grinds. So when I realized that I wasn't going to have any coffee for this morning, I assumed right over to McDonald's and the fast food drive-thru and got three large coffees, and they were so nice. It was later in the day. If I wanted cream and sugar. And I said, no, but could you please make it a fresh pot? I said, I love your coffee, and when I come in the afternoon, it's not fresh. They were so nice. And I did have to wait. You know, I paid, and I had to wait in the little waiting space for a couple minutes, but it wasn't a big deal. And oh my goodness. You guys, if you're a Starbucks addict, and you want an awesome coffee, but you don't want to pay the Starbucks price, you have to try McDonald's coffee. So anyways, what I do, I don't drink super strong coffee, so a large McDonald's coffee, When I bring it home, I dilute it like one cup of McDonald's coffee to one cup of water. Because you always see my coffee. I always put cream in it anyway. But there's such a strong coffee just to begin with. So that'll tide me over for 2 or 3 days, I think. Until I get to the store or order. I should probably just order it on Amazon. I just get real flustered at myself sometimes. Either I have the money, and I don't have the time. I'm real flustered and busy, and I don't have the time to go shopping, or even order it, or the time to. Don't have the money. So, not crazy. such an awesome picture. I can't believe how perfect this picture is. Who's the photographer? Who's their photographer that makes her stuff look so delicious? Oh my goodness. I can't help but wish they had those little smell stickers. Okay, so anyways. What was I talking about? I get so sidetracked when I say that. I need to work on my YouTube channel on the homepage. That just dawned on me. Maybe update the logo. I just have like a generic channel picture for like the backdrop. Maybe I should update it. I'm thinking. I don't know for sure. Where did that phrase come from? It just dawned on me. I wonder where that originated from. Oh. Do you know? I think I come up with good ideas sometimes, but I really do think this is a good idea. Here I am looking. I love these photographs so much that I'm clipping up the magazine and saving these pictures. Do you know how much money they would probably make from me if they had a scratch and sniff on here? If they had, like, each little thing had a scratch and sniff, like a milk chocolate scratch. Sniff, dark chocolate, and then one with a nuts smell, because it smells different than the ones I have. I'm telling you. And they wouldn't even really have to have it on each page, on each picture. If the front of their catalog, if people saw that it had scratch and sniff, this is like comfort food. See, candy for me is like comfort food. I don't have to eat it to get a warm, fuzzy feeling. Just to look at it is totally a warm, fuzzy feeling. Now this is not my favorite dark, but this looks like more like dark chocolate, kind of, doesn't it? Oh, they did that perfect. Wouldn't that be fun to have a deck of playing cards? And on one side it would be candy, boxes of candy. Oh, I should search for that. Or make my own. Get like an old deck of cards. I think I'm onto something here. Listen to this idea, you guys. I just thought of it. This might even be a video. I'm really tired, but maybe I'm more creative when I'm tired. You let me know. Tell me what you think of this. All right, so we could go to Dollar Tree or Walmart or Target or anywhere and get a deck of playing cards. I'm sure really cheap. You know, obviously there's a regular size that are like 4 by 2 inches. I don't know what the measurement is, but regular deck of playing cards. And just use this as an example. Say you have a friend or somebody who has everything. It's like almost everybody has everything. We can get whatever we want. But you want something really special. It's a special friend, let's pretend, or a special family member. Think of this. Think if you got a deck of cards. I think, you know, if it's a grown-up, I'd get the regular deck of cards. If it's a kid, possibly those little kid deck of cards. They're like this size. I know, they're like that. See? Like that. They're like this size. Right? And what if we did this? No, that's not the right size. Darn it. So here we are. Here's the deck. Okay, so here's your kid for children, you know, they have those little deck of cards. Alright, so I should have known. Let's see here. I use this as for the sake of discussion here. So on the back, you have, like, your number. So we'll just say this is number 2 card. Number 2. And then two of clubs or whatever that. Okay, so there's your card, right? Kid would be happy with that, but think of this. What if their favorite thing was chocolate candy? I'll just use that as the example because that's easy to use as the example right now. What if you'd want some good glue. You'd want good glue because you want to make this a nice thing. And then they'd have whatever their favorite thing. myself a deck of cards. I know it's probably an old-fashioned red deck of cards. You can find that really easy at maybe Dollar Tree or Walmart. And then figure out the best clue. Aren't you glad? Aren't you glad you guys tuned in to my channel? I'm just so tired tonight, I can't believe it. Look how cute. What could I do with these pictures? I could make my own greeting cards. I'll make coasters. Some coasters, and then take a brush this like on top and seal it with a good sealer. I need to go to Michael's Crafts. That's what I'm going to do. How about that? See, get a, like, what would be a good size coaster? Well, I have one here. You guys have seen this coaster. See this? Find the coaster that I like, and then take it to Michael's and say, what's the material I use to glue these pictures on top of the coasters and seal it so I can have my own custom-made coasters. I could do that, or just make my own greeting cards. That one says Happy Mother's Day, but I'm gonna get rid of them. I can make like my own little note cards, because I have some blank. I have some blank little note cards, and I can make a ton of them. It says every day is like a box. Alright, something that says, your kindness is contagious. Your kindness, I was going to say like a box of chocolate, that doesn't make sense. you have in common with a box of See's candy? You're both so sweet. I am so tired. I'm sure when I listen to this video, I'll put myself to sleep. This is the bridge mix. I'm not crazy about the bridge, but in a pinch, it'll do. We were visiting somebody yesterday at a retirement facility. It's kind of funny. And right when you go in, we hadn't been there before, but they have like this little candy shop or candy store, and everything's a dollar. And I no sooner got through the front door, we're signing in. I said, "Do you have like stuff we can buy and bring for our friend?" And they said, "Well, there's like a if you want to have lunch and stuff, there's a cafe, a cafeteria. But if you just want some little fun snacks, everything here is a dollar." So we stepped in. And I was like a kid in a candy store. They had every fun thing you can imagine. So I spent $7. Well, I got two soda pops and one bag of chips, one bag of peanuts, one bag chocolate chip cookies, one bag of Oreos. What was the other thing? Oh, you know those Hostess Ding Dongs, the two pack? Hostess Ding Dong, chocolate chip cookies, Oreos, Lay's potato chips, and peanuts, and they were all a dollar. And two soda pops. I spent $7. It was like a little Dollar Tree store inside the nursing facility. So it made our visit fun. And we had a fun visit. And so you would think I'd have something left over. And that's what I was doing as I was picking up all the stuff I wanted. I said, "Oh, this would be fun to have a fun Although I do have one soda pop left and a little bit of peanuts left, so we'll see. so tempted to do something. So if you guys have been watching Dancing with the Stars, I fell asleep the other night. I missed it. I think there's one more show left. I think. Look at how cute that is. So that's been kind of fun. It's always. Dancing with the Stars is so much fun, but it's such a... I would pass out. Look at this. If somebody got me this, the gold box. Gold fancy. Gift of elegance. Gold fancy. Oh, I would pass out. See, it doesn't take much to please me. I can't believe I still have this nail polish on. Well, one finger, that was from the, I believe it was the Ipsy nail polish the other day. You would think I would just get the nail polish remover and take it off. It's sitting right by my little table. I need to do that. think I'm going to do that when I go to See's Candy. I never think of getting the gold box. My mind is always set on the traditional box of nuts and chews. 2-pound box of nuts and chews. Here's another good idea. What about a See's Candy drive-thru window? Oh my gosh. That would be the life of me. Because I was going to show up on the TV news. I notice when I talk about stuff. Have you guys noticed this? When you talk about stuff and then you see it on the news, it's kind of spooky, I think. That's why I don't even use Siri. I know that speaking thing on Google. I don't even use that. I think I found where we left off. Okay, I think I left off with Tamara. It's been a few days since I did comment, you guys. It's been relaxing, really. BB writes, I love your video. So helpful to listen to when my health problems are acting up. Oh, thank you, BB. I'm glad I could help. Okay. Uriel Soriano writes from my C's. Of all things, my C's. Flipping through the C's catalog. I love your video so much, but you might think about improving the quality in general, but really good though. I know, wouldn't that be fun someday? I think if I had a good internet. That would be a start. Thank you, Uriel. But a lot of people just like it the way it is. I kind of like it too, in the respect that I really do believe it's relaxing when you see a lot of fluff and stuff in a video. You can feel the energy and the work and all this stuff that has gone into it. And that takes, for me, I don't know if my senses are just too sensitive, if that makes sense. But sometimes when you see all the perfection and all the stuff and hard work and energy that went into the video, you absorb that and it takes away from your relaxing atmosphere. So anyway, Megan Pierce writes, get the P.O. Box, please. I have sunglasses set aside. Oh, thank you, Megan. And Haley G. writes, it's weird to say, but this totally helped me fall asleep when I played this. I fell asleep, put my headphones on, and I was out in 30 minutes. All the one of the manly man snoring. Morgan McDonald writes, you should get a map and a sticker from the place where your viewers are from. That would be a fun series. Oh my goodness. Remember I was talking about getting a P.O. box and then send me, if you had sunglasses you're going to throw away, I would send them to me and let me know where you're from. Wouldn't that be fun? And get a sticker for everybody that sent something and have a huge map. And a sticker. That is a good idea, Morgan McDonald. Thank you. And Vex Rapid writes, oh, he said he likes the Matchbox video. Thank you, Vex, Morgan. And then Oliver Queen does not like my gum chewing, but Sean Wadsworth says no. That's her signature. Thank you, Sean. And Bill Coffin writes, Belmont Stakes. It's a Kentucky Derby, Preakness, and the Belmont. Can you believe I went blank? I was so excited about the Kentucky Derby. I couldn't remember what last one was. Thank you, Bill. Jose Prendes writes, Happy Mother's Day, Angela. Thank you, Jose. And Sean Wadsworth says, thank you, you're those are the best. Rafeda MC writes, from one of my chewing gum, for me it's gratifying after the stress of the day. When I go to sleep, I connect the headphones and I relax with your videos. And as I get to sleep, almost without realizing, thank you. From all of us, and congratulations to your channel, Angela. Oh, thank you, Rafeda. And Chris Knight Bonds has a $10 off gift card, not greeting cards. Yeah, I probably read that backwards. And David Hendricks, right? Oh, that bread didn't sit well with you. I love to eat entire baguettes. I know, and then I suffer after. By the way, I'm watching you from Madrid, Spain, and I actually grew up in Southern California, in Poway, San Diego County. Yes, I know about Poway. But I've moved to Spain when I was 20. It was 30 years ago. Interesting. David, thank you for your support. Benjamin Kelly writes, oh man, I was loving that little water bottle. It was tingling every time I heard the water splash. This one. Isn't that a fun little sound? Thank you, Benjamin, for your support. And April Nicole writes, I like Michelob Ultra. It's like drinking water.
Oh my goodness, yeah.
Remember the other day, I was drinking a beer, a Bud Light. Oh. I kind of warned people to not get excited. It's a Bud Light and a... And when I drink a light beer, whether it's especially a Michelob Ultra, that's like really like water, and then a Coors Light or a Bud Light, I kind of warned everybody, I said, no, don't.
don't get excited. These light beers are just like water. And I like guzzled it down like within just a few minutes. But sometimes a light beer on a hot day is just so much fun. Thank you, April Nicole. Peaceful wishes, right? This video could not come at a better time. Oh, that's what I was rambling on about Mother's Day. Thank you. My daughter's moving 2 states away for college, and I've been so upset. I don't know why, but your video put me at ease over the situation. What a lovely Mother's Day weekend you had. You're truly blessed with a wonderful family. Oh, Peaceful, thank you for your comment and for watching. And what I tried to, you know, sometimes I feel bad. I never know how you guys are going to receive my videos. But I did want to get the message across to young moms, because I was there at one time. And now both my daughters are grown professionals in their 30s. And there were so many years after they grew up, after high school, when I was just so disgusted with them or flustered and, you know, just really felt that how unthoughtful they were. But it seemed like now that they're in their 30s, it's kind of like gone full circle. So I made the mention for moms, you know, just be patient. It does happen. You know, you have the in-between years. I guess it would be between high school graduation and adulthood in their 30s. And then you, things get better as your kids get older. But so Peaceful, I know what you're talking about. I've been so upset, she said. I remember those years. Oh, it'll pass, Peaceful. Thank you for watching. And Tamara writes about laughing when I was talking about the laundry bags. But you know, you're right. They are, I guess, just laundry bags, but I call them lingerie bags. That's kind of funny, because I never think to put anything in those laundry bags other than lingerie. But you're right. Yeah, that, my daughter, that was so sweet. Next from Galaxy P, right? I love chewing sounds. I guess that's not a very popular option, and I don't get why it irritates people. Well, I guess it's a brain thing. Either you like this or you don't. Yeah, and I must admit, I like the gentle gum chewing. Sometimes I get carried away, and I can understand that, but I try to be gentle with it. Thank you, Galaxy. And Leah Corsino writes, get the P.O. box, please. We'd send you sunglasses and lots of goodies. Thank you. Thank you, Leah. And Blizzard writes, I love this. Oh, from my Juicy Fruit. I did a long, maybe last year I did a Juicy Fruit gum video. Remember Juicy Fruit? Isn't that a fun memory from growing up? Marie Marquez writes, my favorite beer is Mickey's. Never heard of Mickey's unless you're talking about Michelob. Thank you, Marie. And Katrine Clover writes, oh, I had a perfume video, Shalimar perfume with Arabic writing, and she says she interpreted it says for external use only. Thank you, Katrine. Oh, Kathy Stradley, yes, wonderful. She likes my Ulta video, caring for the plants video, and Jess R. loves wonderful tingle-inducing sounds from caring for the plants video. Thank you, you guys, for Kathy and Jess. And Jennifer Pfeiffer writes, I have listened to this every night for bed, and it works every time. Oh, from my 90 minutes from the other night, 90 minutes rambling and celebrity stories. Oh, that's fun. Oh, I guess earlier in the month. Thank you so much. Looks like Stefan Betrick. Thank you for uploading so many original videos. If you could,
upload some more of those typing ones. Keep up the good work. They like my plant video. And Gabby Sprites and Barth writes, oh my goodness, my brain is just melting away here. Time to go to sleep. Thanks for making this video. You are truly one of the best ASMR artists on the tube, and you are amazing. Lovely greetings from Germany. Gabby, thank you. She liked my plant. I'm going to do an extended plant. Caring for the plant. Wasn't that relaxing? Oh my goodness, I love that too. And Joanne Jones, right? I'm not sure if you found out, but Alta does offer a charge card. And that compact you like is free with a $16.50 purchase. Oh my goodness. Thank you, Joanne. And Calypso ASMR is a nice video as always from my browsing the newspaper. Thank you, Calypso. Oh, Benjamin Kelly, you caught me on my Ipsy. I says about my nail polish. This smells nice and hazardous. And that's terrible because I love the smell of nail polish. You know it's totally toxic and terrible. I love the smell of nail polish. The smell of like powerful glue. And the smell of back in the day before they fixed the gas pumps. Like in the 60s and 70s when you could really smell the gas. Isn't that terrible? That was such a fun, cheap thrill for me, smelling the gas. But you can't really do that anymore. Let me know if you're one of the ones who remember that when you could smell the gas, when they had the skinny little nozzles. That one. Mama for Nicole, I love the bag this month. Yes, the Ipsy little ice cream bar bag. How fun was that? Thank you, Mama for Nicole. Appreciate you. And EM1986, right? Smells nice and hazardous. Thanks for the laugh. You guys make me laugh. You catch my little things. I forget some of the stuff I say. Just can't believe some of the stuff I say, but it's still fun. Thank you, EM. And last but not least, we have James Dangello, right? I really enjoy watching all of your videos, Angela. They're relaxing and peaceful to watch from one of my 60-minute keyboarding. Oh, thank you so much. You guys are fun for me, too. So we'll see how this video turns out tonight. I cannot believe what a mishmash video this kind of turned out to be. I'm so tired. I can't believe it. I have so many videos I want to do, so many ideas. And then when it comes, I get so tired. Can't believe it. So anyways. Obviously, I didn't get all my chocolates to cut out next time. It'll be fun. See? You guys don't have to buy me a real box of See's Candy to please me. It's just get me a See's Candy catalog. That's crazy. Anyway. Oops. I still want to do. Also on my list, I want to do like just a whole hour of quietly and calmly lighting matches, letting out burn out, just watching them burn, and then the sound of dipping them. Well, that didn't work. I didn't dip it in water. I dipped it in wax and I almost got myself on fire. I'm gonna try that again. watching the fire, watching me catch myself on fire. Interesting. Look at that. I think I kind of like doing that. Look at how the match burns. The matchstick doesn't break apart. It's just, that's kind of interesting. Okay, one more. We're done with this. I am really tired. Oh, last one. Whoops. Look at that. Usually after I do matches, they all crumble apart. Look, if you dip it in wax, they don't crumble apart. They turn into like these long spidery things. Weird. That'd be fun to do a whole video of that. I'm watching.